I wonder what Tina's art is. Shouldn't she be home by now?
Why, yes. I expected her long before this. I do hope nothing has happened to her.
There's a strange man out there. Let's suppose he's headed for here.
Oh, I'm so anxious to meet my cousin Dorothea. I'm looking forward to enjoying many gay time with her.
Yes, the fellow's coming here. And it looks as though he's carrying a girl in his arms.
Oh! Oh!
Yeah!
Met with a little accident, but she'll be all right. Where'll I put her?
Oh, place the poor child there on the sofa, if you please.
What's happened to my daughter, man?
Well, her horse was running away with her, and it looked like it was going to throw the young lady, so I chased after her, pulled her off the horse, and brought her home.
Well, how did you know where my daughter lives, young man?
Oh, well, she told me. You see, she didn't faint until it was well on her way here.
My wife and I are very grateful to you for being so kind to our daughter.
Well, shucks, I didn't do nothing. Any galoot would have done the same. Well, I best be getting on my way.
Oh, no, you mustn't go yet. Oh, you must be tired out from carrying me. Sit down and rest a bit, won't you?
Well, I reckon I can stay a little while if you want me to.
Oh, I certainly do.
Roger, get a doctor immediately.
That's not at all necessary, Mother.
I'll be as good as new after I've rested a bit. Do you think you can make it up to your room, dear?
Of course. You saved my life. Promise me that you won't go away without letting Father know where he can get in touch with you.
All right, I promise.
Lean on me, dear. I shall insist that you see a doctor and have a quick checkup in the morning. Come along, Rodney. We'll meet your hair.
Come in, my
dog. It was the first time I had ever been face to face with a real hero.
Well, I ain't no hero. I just believe in always helping any fair damsel in distress.
Those noble sentiments do him proud. It is easy to see that here is a man among men.
Lend a hand.
Yes, I know you love Dorothea half, but what is your name?
Lend a hand.
Oh, very well. If your name is a secret, I don't wish me to know it.
Well, no, miss, I just told you my name. It's Lend a Hand. Burgess Lend a Hand.
Burgess Lend a Hand. That's my name for a young hero.
And now, in turn, you must tell me your name.
Gladly, I'm called.
My dear Dorothea is asking for you. Won't you come up to her room?
Well, of course, Uncle Ronnie. I'll be right up.
You don't have to go upstairs right now, do you? Can't you stay here and talk with me for a few minutes?
Sorry, but I believe in doing things the instant you're told to do them. The only person that profits by letting things slide is the trombone player.
You tell him. You sure have the lips for it.
What a presence of the humor he possesses. This man has everything for which to win a maiden's heart. If you like, you may come upstairs and talk with Uncle Rodney.
Well, I can paint you Cousin Dorothea.
It's a deal. I ain't never met a flower before this, and well, I'm gonna stick around and watch you grow.